So is Facebook dead? Absolutely not. With over 2 billion monthly active users, it's never been a better time to build your influence on Facebook. And in this video, I interview the queen, Mari Smith, of Facebook, and she breaks down some ninja tactics for how to get more organic reach on your posts, how to use video to reach more people and build your business, and some really cool tricks that I've never heard before about Facebook. You're gonna love it all, and it's coming up right now. Hey, welcome back to Video Influencers. I am Sean Cannell, and I'm so excited because today I'm standing with the queen of Facebook, Mari Smith, for our annual Facebook video update on the best practices, tactics, and strategies for growing your business and brand with Facebook. Of course, video, of course, stories, but we're going to unpack everything. Mari, it's so good to have you back on the show.
Thanks for having me, Sean. I look forward to this every year.
Yeah, it's so fun. For the past few years, you've been helping us with some great tactics. In fact, those past videos, we'll link to those in the description. You've given us strategies, you've given us best practices. But as we get into today, I would love to know just about the landscape of Facebook right now. There's so many new platforms with TikTok. Of course, we talk a lot about YouTube here. And sometimes Facebook can have kind of almost like a misunderstood brand or kind of an interesting brand. What's the real deal with Facebook in 2020 right now?
The real deal is absolutely going all in on video. Video is the best top of funnel, most affordable, most reach and most engagement, best reach, engagement and price point in terms of building that know, like, and trust factor, getting the awareness. And then what you can do is you're going to go ahead and go into Ads Manager and start creating your custom audiences based on people who viewed your videos. Now, ideally, you're going to go past the 3 second. You're going to go 10, 15 second, half the whole video, even as much as 90% of the whole video, building and building, building your audience on that, doing lookalikes. And actually, my talk here at Social Media World this year is specifically on organic. So even though with a tiny nominal budget, you can get exceptionally better organic reach, or even with no payment, no ad spend whatsoever. I'm going to be sharing several examples of where these particular marketers on Facebook have really kind of hit the jackpot. And a big part of that is because they're just consistently publishing great quality video that resonates with their audience.
Are you saying that we should start potentially with organic video uploads and then based on the consumption of those, then follow up with paid targeting and ads for those that have consumed and basically said, I'm interested in more by watching the videos we're uploading?
Yes. So the video views is a brilliant way to present to a cold audience. People, a lookalike is a great example of a cold audience because they don't necessarily know you yet. So they see the video going by, always with the text overlay, always with something compelling, ditch all the fancy logos and stuff at the beginning and just go right in those first 3 seconds and grab the attention. And then start to build that whole sequence, if you will, and get to know, have people know, like, and trust you through the videos. And now you're going to retarget the warm audience with, you could do a traffic, if you're driving them specific to a landing page. It could be a lead ad where you're collecting specifically their email, their phone. It could be a click-to-messenger ad. If you could have a chatbot installed on there, and those are really powerful ways. Then the third phase is you're going to move over to the conversion ads, depending on what you're selling, B2C, B2B, product versus service, but the conversion ads, where you really want to be targeting your hot audience, your people who have, they've begun to know you, begun to interact with you. And this is one of the biggest mistakes that I see advertisers making, is where they will take a cold audience. Maybe it's built from their pixel, their website visitors, or it's built from video views or their email list, but it's still a cold audience. They're not familiar with you yet. And they go straight to conversion and they go straight to trying to sell. And for some advertisers that might work, but Facebook, as you said, like, just the whole brand of Facebook, it's like, we have to remember that always, first and foremost, this is a social network. People come to YouTube knowing that that's where they don't do anything else but watch video. They might engage and have a, you know, network and whatever, but it's all about the video. On Facebook, there's a lot of other properties. There's a lot of other things to do on Facebook. Video is just one of them. And so remembering that as a marketer, a saying I've had for many years is that the secret to success on social media, especially Facebook, is to think and act and behave as a member first and a marketer second. Because nobody wakes up in the morning and goes, oh, gee, you know, I wonder what this brand is posting on their Facebook page today, they open up Facebook and they're looking at their friends and their family members, and then maybe their wider circle after that. Then maybe they're thinking about what business is doing.
Got it. So it's all about intent. Remember what they're there for. Mm-hmm. And you're saying if you basically rush the process, if you don't go through the steps to kind of warm the audience up, have mm-hmm. them get to know you, connect with them with a few different pieces of content. I love that. Now, one of the big things you hear about Facebook is that organic reach is dead. Mm-hmm. And so what are some of the tips and best practices that are working for people to get organic reach with their content on Facebook?
Right. So absolutely, videos, we've said it, uploaded natively. I would stay away from sharing a YouTube link on Facebook. At the same time, I actually recommend still testing, like Social Media Examiner. I know that Mike's going really heavily more into YouTube than Facebook. And so he will post his YouTube links on Facebook. And I've just been watching the views. And whereas I have some of the people in my community where I've seen them go completely ridiculously viral, like 50 million views on a YouTube video posted on Facebook. So there's always outliers. Generally speaking, I would say you're going to go native. Now then, a hot tip that I think a lot of marketers and page owners are not familiar with is when you've loaded up that video, let's say you get 10,000 views and that's on a post and you made it last week. Now, depending on the size of your page, if you only have a few fans, but if you have a decent number of fans, you know, 5,000 plus, then you're going to go into Creator Studio, you're going to go to your video library, you're going to go into, there's that video that you just got 10,000 views on, click that little guy, and you're going to create a fresh post, different narrative, different call to action, different link. But those 10,000 views are still tacked onto that video, and it's cumulative. So you can keep using the same video, and ideally, if you do have evergreen content, that's like the holy grail. You can keep going back in and reusing, recycling, repurposing old video content, but it doesn't carry the old date with it, but it carries all the cumulative views. So that's a really good one. I also like to drive traffic from other sources. Let's say I've done a Facebook Live, and then I will do many things with it, but I will go ahead and you're going to optimize it, put your title in there, your keywords, and your captions. Do that text overlay.
And for your captions, is it okay to just use the Facebook captions? Is that the best tool to use? Or are you saying embedded, edit in captions?
Oh, well, you can't do the text overlay once a video is done on Facebook. There's no doing that. But the actual captions, the captions tool, fortunately, Facebook's AI has gotten significantly better. A lot
And you can
better.
Go in there and make some corrections and it's perfect.
It's very, very similar to YouTube. But for example, if I do a lot of brand ambassador work, so I'm getting actually paid to do a Facebook Live, paid to do a promotion, I want to make certain that it's really, really good accuracy. And I would just go to rev.com, I'll pay for the actual human transcription, and I go back and load up the SRT file. But meantime, just go for at least if you just even edit the first 1 minute to make sure your captions are solid, then you should be good to go. Now then, I'm going to my email newsletter, I take that permalink, and I'm saying, hey guys, we've got a great conversation going over here, whatever it might be about, and I'll just say, come join the discussion. Click, and they go straight to the video. Then, something, an underutilized tool on Facebook, we might have talked about this last year, is the watch party. And a watch party is really an ingenious tool on Facebook, and I see that it's not used as much with marketers. So I would go over to, maybe I'll do it in my group. I have a group called Social Scoop. We've got about 7,000 members in there. Even if I've already gone live on my page, you know, last week, a few days ago, not everybody's going to see it. Now I'm going to say, hey guys, I'm going to be live in the comments with you. We're going to do a watch party and we're going to go deeper into this topic. Ask me your questions. Super cool thing you can do on desktop or mobile. You can jump in live. You can do a live video over or voiceover. It doesn't get recorded in the watch party, but it's a really cool feature.
How does that look? So it's playing. Does it go side by side with it when you?
No, it's like you know Loom. You know the Loom video. So it's like a little teeny wee circle down on the bottom left.
Yeah.
It's similar to that. So
it's like you're reacting and commentating.
Yeah. And I would recommend pause the video because it won't automatically pause. So I'll hit the little live video, or sometimes if I'm not camera ready, I'll just do a live audio, and then the wee circle just pops up, and it'll either be like with the, it's like little ripples if it's audio, but if you're on camera, it'll have your face. So it's a tiny little picture. It's like you're bigger than all the pictures of the people watching, but it's a super cool effect. People like, oh my God, was that you right there live, Mari? Even though they're like watching a video of me, or might not be of me, but it's like a cool feature that not enough people are using, and it's free. It's totally organic.
Wow. So there's so much opportunity on Facebook. This is exciting because I'm even kind of getting reinvigorated for our Facebook strategy. We need to be posting videos. We can be tapping into the power of then posting them organically and, of course, paid video ads. We should be using groups. You touched on groups and then doing watch parties. But I'm also curious about some of what's happening with Facebook stories. And, of course, so that's another format of video.
Yeah. So we all know that Instagram really kind of dominates in the world of stories, right? 500,000 daily. I always think this is such a powerful stat to drive home. Those 500,000,000 users, they're daily.
Yeah.
They're not creators, they're consumers, right? There's probably, I don't know, the 80-20 rule of consumers, I mean of creators. But then the vast majority of us are simply setting it up, auto-post, set and forget to cross-post them over either to our profile or our business page. And that's what I choose to do, is I cross-post, I have a creator profile on Instagram, and I cross-post it over to my business page. Then I save it to my camera roll, and I will repurpose some of those at a different time, so it's not all lining up at the same time. Repurpose those little video clips, pop them up to my personal profile. So now you're getting extra usage out of it. But I just feel like the actual, like, really strong use case of native Facebook stories is still a little sticky. But Facebook's like, at every opportunity, they're trying to make those cards, they call them, right? On Instagram, it's like the wee circles, but on Facebook, it's like these giant big, you know, and then you be scrolling through your feed and then there's another whole row of them. So it's like, you will get used to stories. And then we were just talking offline there that Messenger last week literally had a brand new overhaul, and they got rid of the Discover tab. So in place of the Discover feature on the Messenger, if you tap your wee people icon, it's now Stories. And Stories are also coming over from, if you post to your Facebook personal profile, they're automatically in your Messenger Stories. And so, again, 500,000,000 dailies with Facebook and Messenger combined. I would say we're going to start seeing throughout 2020 more and more and more feature improvements on the Facebook Stories product and getting more and more people to create for it. Because the more, let's say you're great on your Instagram stories. Let's say you post 10 stories a day on Instagram. Those 10 stories is giving Facebook an opportunity. Like, you're literally creating the ad inventory for them, like the space to put ads in. So the more we create those as creators, the more Facebook has inventory to sell for the ads. And they're automatically placed there anyway if you use your automatic placement on Ads Manager.
Gotcha. So there, it's kind of still a little bit clunky. And would you say that a general thing, though, is that if you're doing Instagram stories, you can do the auto post to Facebook might as well?
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
And so that way you're getting more reach there. And as we kind of land the plane, and I want to get some final tactical tips from you, but if you're getting value out of this video, hit the like button and let me know in the comments if you've been active on Facebook, if you're getting reinvigorated for your Facebook strategy, tell us in the comments. And what is your favorite social media platform right now where you're most active? Let us know. But Mari, I'm curious because as I'm kind of hearing this, it's just reminding me of maybe the importance of mastery in social media, like to really maximize Facebook. You don't just go over there and like share YouTube links once a week and think that's going to change anything.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
You want to be present. If you're maximizing live streaming and you're uploading videos and you have a paid strategy and you're using groups and you're using Messenger bots and active in Messenger and you're potentially using stories and you're tapping into all of the collective Facebook features strategically, that's why there's people that are getting results, because they're taking action, but they're not just, they don't have a surface level understanding. It sounds like they're really, you need to go to a mastery level on Facebook to maximize and squeeze it for all it's worth. Would that be true?
It was absolutely true. And the other thing too is that they're invariably, Facebook's changing things up. There's a feature there one day and it's not the next, or it's acting well one day and then it's buggy the next. And so that it caused an enormous amount of frustration for users and marketers alike. But even just finding out like small little ninja tips, like one that one of my colleagues shared with me last week, is one of my organic examples I'm going to be using in my talk here at Social Media World, is that Facebook knows who is making the post on the page. And he's got a large page, his friend of mine, Stephen Aitchison, and he has 4 million people on his fan page. And Facebook will give him more reach if he personally makes the post, being the original creator of the page, versus people he's added later as admins.
Wow.
So, hot tip for you there.
That's really hot, yeah.
You know, yeah. May as well, we're talking about organic reach. You're the one that you created the page, you own the page, you're the master admin, but you, if you can take the moment to be the one that creates the original posts,
sure,
you might find a lift in your reach.
That's so powerful. And I know we've been talking a lot about video, but recently I just did a recap from a conference that I went to, and it was a blog post, a lot of rich copy, a lot of insights, a lot of value. And for me, the post really blew up. More engaged than I've seen recently.
Nice.
Tons of comments as a long form text post.
Nice.
So what would you say in terms of a variety of posting and even on your content? Are you doing photos, text, both, videos, lives? Is that mix help with organic reach as well?
Absolutely. I'm really glad that you brought this point up, because I typically have been recommending for about a year now that you do 70% video, which includes live, as much live as you can do, but 70% video, 20% photos, images, graphics, and only 10% link posts. But here's the key. The people are like, oh my God, I want to share my blog post. I want to drive traffic back to my site. I got the pixel there. Guess what? You can absolutely do that with video and photo. I'm not saying don't put a link in your at all, but put a link in your video or your photo. Also, even if you go to like literally pretend to boost a post, and you can get the call to action button that will append to the bottom of the video. Or you could.
What do you mean by that, pretend?
So you hit the boost button, you put all your parameters in, and then you just like cancel out of it.
But now you dial that link.
Or you wait for it to be approved. You can put as much money as you want on it, and then you're like, head it to be approved, and then you change your mind and just pause the ad.
But yet that cool visual link that's underneath would then be there, and it will stay
the button,
there.
The call to action button will be there, and it'll stay there.
All the tips, influencers, all the tips here. Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah. So, but the ratio part, absolutely. I love that you mentioned about long form, because the thing is, once people are on a platform, they're on Facebook, they're there usually because they enjoy it and they want to consume great content that's either educational, entertaining, or inspirational. And if you're a good writer and you're adding value, they will stick with you. And, you know, and same with video. People say, like, you've got that text overlay and it's valuable. It's not just fluffy nonsense, unless your page is about fluffy nonsense.
Yeah.
Then, yeah, you got a captive audience. Absolutely. Mix it up. Test. I know questions do really well. You can just do one simple, powerful question and no visuals whatsoever, no links. And that can really blow up as well.
Man, I love it. Mari Smith, how can people connect with you, and what are some of the best places to reach you and resources you have?
Yeah, absolutely. So, of course, my Facebook page, at Mari Smith, one with the blue check. And then I have a really, really active Facebook group. It's called Social Scoop. They can get all kinds of wonderful peer support.
Free to join?
Totally free to join.
Awesome.
It's really a very active group. We've got about 7,000 folks in there. A lot of social media practitioners. You need help with ads or whatever you're doing. Good access to myself and my team. On my website, of course, marismith.com, Twitter, Instagram. They can find me.
Mari, thanks so much for coming back on the show. Influencers, if you got value, hit like. And if you haven't seen it yet, recently we did a video with Michael Stelzner. We're here at Social Media Marketing World about the 2020 social media trends across the board. So click or tap the screen to watch that video next, or another video from Video Influencers, and we will see you in the next video. Peace.